हेलो एट क्लास स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल कंटिन्यू अवर चैप्टर नंबर 2. सो टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम दिस टॉपिक यूजिंग फार्मूला ऑन टेक्स्ट. वी कैन आल्सो परफॉर्म एडिशन ऑन करेक्टर एंड स्ट्रिंग डाटा टाइप. इट मींस इफ यू वांट टू जॉइन टू करेक्टर्स और टू वर्ड्स, स्ट्रिंग मींस टू वर्ड्स, देन इट इज़ आल्सो पॉसिबल इन माइक्रोसॉफ्ट एक्सेल. एक्सेप्ट फॉर एडिशन, अदर ऑपरेशंस लाइक सब्ट्रैक्शन, मल्टीप्लीकेशन, डिवीजन एक्सेट्रा आर नॉट अलाउड ऑन द स्ट्रिंग डाटा टाइप्स. मीन्स यू कैन ज्वाइन द टू वर्ड्स और करेक्टर्स, बट यू कैन नॉट डू सब्ट्रैक्शन, मल्टीप्लीकेशन और डिवीजन ऑन दैट वर्ड्स. द एम्फसाइज सिंबल इज यूज टू परफॉर्म एडिशन. लाइक वी आर यूजिंग प्लस सिंबल टू एड टू नंबर्स. हियर इफ यू वॉन्ट टू ज्वाइन टू स्ट्रिंग्स और टू टेक्स्ट और टू करेक्टर्स, देन वी आर यूजिंग इंस्टेड ऑफ प्लस वी आर यूजिंग दिस एम्फसाइज सिंबल्स. एडिशन ऑफ टू और मोर टेक्स्ट वैल्यू इज कॉल्ड कॉन्कैटिनेशन. एंड वैन वी ज्वाइन टू वर्ड्स, देन दैट टर्म इज नोन एज कॉन्कैटिनेशन. लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड विद द हेल्प ऑफ एग्जाम्पल. वी विल टेक टू सेल्स. इन ए वन सेल वी राइट किप्स एंड इन बी वन सेल वी विल राइट इंडिया. Then if you want to join this one, how we'll write? We'll write is equal to A1 and B1. This one ampersand sign we will write, put between them. And then in C1 cell we'll write, then it will give the output like this way. We can see it practically also. I will show you. Like in the A1 cell I have written here Kips, and in the B1 cell I have written India. Then in the C1 cell I will write is equal to A1, this sign, ampersand sign, then B1. It will join these two words. So this is called, we can say, formula applied on the text. Now next one is, there is one note is given also. You can add space between the joined values by enclosing single space. If you want space between them, like Kips India you want to join but you want space also, then in that case what is the format to write? Then we write is equal to and this ampersand sign, then double quote start, space, double quote close, and again ampersand sign, and B1 will be written. Now let's see practically also. If we write here instead of this one, then the formula bar we can change, you know, then we can use this one and then press the enter key after clicking here, then it will give space between them. In this way we can join the two words. Next topic is, what is the cell range? A range is a group of contiguous cells which form the shape of rectangle. It can be a group of two or two cells, or as a big, as an entire worksheet. You can specify a range by writing the starting cell address followed by the ending cell address, both separated by a colon. For example, C1 to C10 indicates a range of starting from C1 and ending with the C10 cell. For this purpose, like you have written some units, you can see what is range. First I will show you what is range. Like we have written some values here, like 67, 68, then 90, 56, 56. So like that with some values we have done. Then we select these values. This is called, we have selected range. So what is this cell number? Cell number E2 to E6 I have selected. So this is called the range from E2 to E7. So when I will do any sum of these cells, then it will, when we will select this one by marks, then it will take the ratio by itself, E2 to E6. So this is called a range. When we select the range means continuously, contiguous means लगातार जब हम कुछ cells को एक या one or two or more than one cells we are selecting, then it is called a, you can say, range. Now to select the range there are different ways. Let's see in the, so first we click on the first cell in range while holding down the left mouse button. Second we can say select the first cell of the range and then press F8 key, and this one also we can use shift key also to select the cell. So let's see these three methods how to select any range. First we will see by using left mouse. With the help of left mouse button you can select like this way. You can press with the left mouse button and drag it. This is the first method. Second, how you can select? By pressing the shift key. Just shift key you press and with the arrow key you select. And third is by using F8 key. You click in the first cell and press the F8 key, and then you will use the arrow key. You can select up to where you want to select. F8 key jab tak aapki press hai, up to which range you want to select, it will be selected automatically. So if you want to deselect this F8 key, you can press the F8 key again. So this is the method to select the range. If you want to use formula in the range, already I shown you is equal to sum, then B2 to B7 it will automatically take, then it can use the formula, or you can say using a range in formula. Now we'll see how we can name a range. If we want to give naming a range, if you want to give like this range is there from cell B2 to B7, you want to give name to this range, and instead of this B2 to B7 you want to use range name here like this way. So let's understood it practically how we can do. We will input some values in Excel sheet, like I will write also 1000, 2000, 3000 or 3900, you can say 4000, 5000. So these are some values. Now how we can give name to these values? For this we will first, what we will select this one, then we will go on formulas tab and then define name. And define name, we will click on the define name, then here we will give the name to the range, like we have given here unit. So it should be keep in mind before doing this one, this range should be selected, range should be come here. So which range we have selected, that range refers to in box, it will come automatically. Then we will click OK. So now this range name is what? That is define name. Now we want to use this range, like we have done is equal to sum, then bracket start, and this range we want to use, then we can use it from the using formula and unit. This range name will come and automatically unit will come here, and then we press the bracket and then press the enter key. Oh, some error has come because in this already this we have also used this cell in the range. So I will write here again is equal to sum, then bracket start, then using formula unit, then bracket close, then press the enter key. So why it has not come here? Maybe this range already we have selected, already it has used. Let's see, do it once again. We will write some values here. Okay, I will give this name, select the range, define name. In name box I have given like this name, CKY. This range I have given name Lucky, then okay. Then here I want to use this range is equal to sum bracket start, then here the name of the this range is unit, then we will close the bracket and press the enter key. See, in this way it will work. So you can select the range again. I am showing you, we will select the range and from here define name, we will give the name, and then in this box you will type the name, click OK. Where you want to use the range name, then you can select that range, and here you can write is equal to sum, like which range you want to select, that range you can use, and then press bracket and press the enter key. So here this range may be not coming. Here we can use is equal to sum, this range also, lucky range also, then press the bracket and enter. So in this way it will use the here. So in this way we can use the formula in the range. Thank you.